Welcome to the video. The studio is not available at this time, so I'm going to plan an alternative plan here. I believe it's going to work just fine for us. The affirmation of the day is a very, very powerful affirmation. It's so powerful that I've been experiencing effects from it, actually. And it is, I am innocent. I am innocent. Say that with great determination. Not questioning, not begging, not asking, not pleading, not thinking, not maybe. I am innocent. I am innocent. I am innocent. I am innocent. Another form to include the totality of it. All is innocent. 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 I am innocent. I am innocent. So I was doing this this morning, and there are so many shifts taking place within the depth of my structure, which we take to be our personality, our form of expression, let's put it the way, the structure of expression, including the body, that I sat up in bed to get up, and I almost blacked out and collapsed backwards, almost fainted. I said, what in the world? That's never happened to me before. And so I've been very shaky today, lightheaded and shaky. Blood pressure's okay. 130 over 74, little high. So I don't know what's going on, but I tried applying this. I am innocent. I am innocent. I felt this in my brain, as it were, a big reaction. Like, whoa, this is a very, very profound affirmation, and it seems to be having immense effects upon me. I am innocent. I am innocent. Don't have any concept of what you're innocent to. This just refers to the totality of all. I am innocent, period. Not innocent of this, not innocent of that. What am I innocent of? No, none of that. Just state with determination, I am innocent. I am innocent. Okay, I am innocent. So this is perhaps in response to all the prayers. Receiving an affirmation like this and being able to apply it is a great, great leap forward. Now, there are those who believe that, myself included, July 15th was like a drop-dead date. From this period on, from July 15th through July 15th of 2016, is a two-year period of utmost relevance in the world. And so the release of this affirmation on July 16th, the morning of July 16th, is a tremendous, tremendous leap forward for us and a protection for us. I really believe it's a tremendous protection in response to all the prayers that have been set forth here. And I'm testing it out on myself, essentially. And will continue to do so. The next 2 years are going to see, we're not even going to think about what it is going to see. But let's just say it's going to be a wild ride the next 2 years, more wild than any of us really care to ride on. So we have the affirmations, and then this seems to be the granddaddy of all affirmations. I am innocent. All is innocent. All is innocent. Wow. It is just profound to the root of my being. So I can feel to the entire depths of my being just resonating everywhere. And that's probably why I'm feeling lightheaded and today. It was so impactful. So if you should happen to feel a little lightheaded and a little unstable, if you do any of the affirmations, don't be surprised. Don't be surprised. So far, I'm able to function okay, but I'm taking it easy today. I feel kind of weak. Maybe that's because I cut back on eating so much. But this does have something to do with the affirmation. I am innocent. I am innocent. Universal innocence. I'm proclaiming a universal state of innocence. Okay? I'm innocent. I am complete. I am innocence itself. Our identity is innocence itself. Proclaim it. Proclaim it. Claim it for yourself. That is protection. That is protection from what is to come. Now, to take a brief little side excursion here, For some reason, I was testing out some of the Google safe search thing. There's a problem with the on the YouTube with the comments. What you need to do is go down to the bottom of the page, and there's a little button down there, a little menu button. You click on it, it says safe search, search. Click on it, it says safe search on, safe search off, and you click off, I guess, and that enables the comments to show up on your page. Beneath the videos. So I was happened to be checking out images on I locked safe search on my computer for Google, locked it, and has some balloons up in the right corner to show you safe search. I went into images, and indeed the balloons did show up there. I said, okay, I typed in Jesus, let's search for pictures of Jesus just as a test. And as I was looking down, I just looked at Derek's pictures. I always tend to look and see, is there any picture of Jesus that actually tends to actually look like Jesus? And I've never found any pictures, actually drawings, actually representations that actually look like Jesus, that as I know Jesus to be. And then I saw one picture and I said, hey, you know what? That actually does look like Jesus. Says, yeah, this is a pretty good facsimile of Jesus. It's very different than most, actually. And it's going to be shocking for people. I'm going to show it to you in a moment here. Very positive, very blissful, just a wonderful, confident, you know, just radiating a sense of I am innocent. You know, I am totally innocent and happy and so here is a picture, here's a drawing, painting that I would say comes close to how Jesus actually appears. If we were to see him, Jesus might look like this. Let's take a look. Okay, so this is somewhat different than we're used to, but you can see just this sort of unbridled joy and confidence and happiness. I guess he's by the Sea of Galilee there with his hand on a net. You don't see any suffering. You don't see someone, you know, in agony of his mission here. So you see someone that knows that I am innocent, that all is innocent, all is innocent. You kind of the hairstyle, the facial features, the big smile, everything is there. This is how Jesus would appear. Somewhat like this, actually. The eyes are just, you know, just shining with positivity, shining with the whole countenance is shining with positivity, knowing what your true identity is. Jesus knows what our true identity is, and that is why he's lit up like this, just super super positive, super super positive, super confident, absolutely certain about the truth of what we are. And that is, we are not a body, we are free. We are as God created us to be. You see, we are not a body, we are free. We are spirit as God created us to be. I am not a body, I am free. I am spirit as God created me. We are not bodies, we are free. We are spirit as God created us to be. And so, here is a picture of spirit knowing the truth of this, a painting actually, and radiating that certitude towards us. So Jesus is a very happy, blissful countenance in all the various, what I've seen of so many, this comes the closest actually to what I've seen. It's not, of course, it's not perfect by any means, but it does give us a glimpse of just the joyous certitude that Jesus actually is. And so I know I came across a website of somebody who had left Christianity and become an atheist. Okay, there's many people like that these days. And what I took from it is that, you know, he was throwing out the baby with the bathwater. He was basically criticizing evangelicalism and then rejecting Christ on that basis. And that's throwing out the baby with the bathwater. Really, also, if I look at all the religious teachings in the world about Jesus, I don't really find that many that really come close to what his real teaching actually is. But is that any reason to reject Christ, reject Jesus, reject God, reject the Holy Spirit, just because there's some particular teachings that claims to be about the Trinity that is somewhat a little maybe off base, or the emphasis isn't what you like, or the theology is warped, or whatever? Why reject the truth of the Trinity just because the way it's being symbolized doesn't appeal to you? And yet that's what many are doing. And I just find that to be very sad, very unfortunate. Because here is a source, here is a help that says, I know that, you are not a body. He would say, look, say this, we are not bodies, we are free. We are spirit as God created us to be. And so this is a tremendous source of help for us. And so the Holy Spirit receiving the affirmation, I am innocent. We are innocent. We are innocent. We are innocent. I am innocent. Absolutely true. It just has an incredible effect on the structure of my expression here. We have no idea of how deluded this whole scenario is here. It's a delusional scenario. It has nothing to do with what we are. Jesus has told us that this world of bodies, this realm and world of bodies, has absolutely nothing to do with what we are. And in fact, doesn't remind us in the slightest bit of the truth of what we are and the reality of our true kingdom. Doesn't remind us in the slightest bit. Okay, nothing to do with what we are, doesn't remind us in the slightest bit. So by saying, I am innocent, we are saying, I am innocent of all of this. I am truly innocent of all of this. I claim my true innocence. All of this realm has nothing to do with what I am. It's all false accusations. It's all a false picture of what I am. I am actually innocent. I am innocent. And I'm getting reaction from this as I'm saying this now. I am innocent. Profound. Very, very profound. And it's thanks to Jesus who told us, look, it's okay if you don't like me, if you want to curse me, it's okay. If you want to curse God, it's okay, but don't curse the Holy Spirit, because I've sent the Comforter to you to clarify everything for you, to clarify everything for you. And that's what the Holy Spirit is doing. And if you just ask the Holy Spirit, ask and you shall receive. I ask for, give me something that can help in this time, that I feel the incredible turmoil of this time. It's on now, July 16th, 2014. I can feel it. And here came this great, great, great affirmation. I am innocent. I am innocent. I am innocent. And you might want to try this. You might want to try it. I think maybe people are too frightened. They want to start off with something that's not very effective, right? I understand that. That's what I've done, of course. You're afraid of the effectiveness because You just may change your entire structure of expression here. And that may happen to me, as a matter of fact. But I said, okay, fine. I'm got nothing to lose at this point, actually. So I might as well just go for it. But you might want to try it out just a little bit, just to sort of get your feet wet. I am innocent. Try it like for 10 minutes or so. I am innocent. I am innocent. I am innocent. Don't try to figure out the meaning of it. Just feel spiritually, feel intuit the feeling, I am innocent. And it just seems to cascade throughout the being here, the expression of being that we have here with bodies and words and feelings and actions and reactions and interpretations and perception and thoughts. It seems to reverberate and cascade through all of that. I am innocent. I am innocent. I am innocent. I am innocent. Yeah. That's hitting hard. Wow, this one truly does hit hard. Whew, feeling a little lightheaded. Wow. Well, this is great news for everybody. That we have this powerful, powerful affirmation that that can dissolve all the lies. Dissolve the whole. We don't need to turn to the news. We don't need to turn to the news. Say, what do we do? You know, what do we do? Media outlet. What do we do? Television channel. What do we do? Blogger. What do we do? You know, pundit. What do we do? Commentator. What do we do? Radio talk show host. What do we do? Whatever. We can turn to these affirmations, say, I am innocent, 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 I am innocent. We don't even need to turn to various philosophies, various explanations, even non-dual explanations. We don't even need to turn to explanations anymore. I believe that phase is come to an end. Because soon in the world, we're going to get to boom, 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 1, 2, 3 situation that will really just trigger everybody's insanity here on this planet. And there's a ton of insanity to trigger, actually. A ton of insanity. You think everybody you see walking around this world is sane? No way. No way. It's a facade. It's a facade, and pretty soon this whole facade is going to come crashing down in the world, and incivility will rule, unfortunately. And so where are you going to go in these times for true stability? And what I say is go to the affirmations. Go to the affirmations. I've worked with Jesus for 36 years now, and intense work. And he always just said one thing to me, hurry up, go faster, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up, time is very short, hurry up. That's it. He just said, keep doing. He said, you're doing great, but just hurry up faster. Come on, you got to reach a certain level in time. So hopefully I have. Hopefully I've gotten to the level on July 16th here. I am innocent. I am innocent. And that is strong enough to turn the tide. Strong enough to turn the tide of these times. Strong enough to turn the tide of these times. So whatever I have got to, it's because of Jesus and the Holy Spirit, actually. And a lot of help along the way from many. But behind it all is Jesus and the Holy Spirit, who was adamant that he says we have to get to practicing these simple, powerful statements. All the explanation is fine, but that's a backdrop for the actual practices themselves. He said, if you don't do the practices, it's not going to work for you. And so somehow I've been able to get to these practices very reluctantly, you know, but I did it. And so that's all that counts, you know. You get to the finish line, you get to the finish line. That's all that counts. In time. You get to the finish line in time. Without a moment to spare, that is for sure. So Jesus, you just imagine, say, I am innocent. I am innocent. I am innocent. This is literally can turn the tide of the entire situation now. So we're going to realize that we're going to have a, there's this tide in the world, which is incredible, you know, high tide or low tide, whatever you want to call it. It's an extreme tide. Let's put it that way. We're in time, an extreme, extreme tide in the affairs of this planet. And we will be shocked by how high the tide, by how extreme the tide is. Absolutely shocked, as if we're not already. I mean, the last 15 years have just been absolutely shocking on this planet of the virulence of the times. But now we're going to experience the extreme virulence of these times. And you will not be able to deal with it rationally, explanation, discussion-wise, anything, any way except through these positive affirmations. So we have this wonderfully positive drawing now of Jesus that is just inviting us to affirm the truth. Don't discuss the truth, affirm it. Affirm the truth, okay? This is where we're at right now, okay? Now, some will be able to do this, some not. Some will say, well, I don't know. I kind of want to just kind of keep on reading explanations. And, you know, but at some point, I think people will get it and they'll say, hey, wait a minute. You know, I think I better try shifting over to these positive affirmations. I am innocent. I am innocent. Okay. Now, there have been, you know, many in the world who offering up various affirmations. That's fine. Here, I ask the Holy Spirit. I say, Holy Spirit, what do you suggest? And just wait for an answer. Just wait for something in my mind to say, I am innocent. And it's like, wow. I said, that sounds like it's it. Let me try it. And I try it out. And I can tell how powerful and effective it is. And I say, you know what? That came from the Holy Spirit. It didn't come from my personality. It came from the Holy Spirit. I am innocent. Whew. Very potent. You know, so a lot of people at this time are going to turn towards us. I have said, because the tide is so extreme, it's going to require something to turn that tide, turn the tide back. And the fact is, only these extremely powerful and effective affirmations from the Holy Spirit are effective enough to do this. But most people in the world will turn to something else, and it will not be good enough. They'll turn, for instance, to marijuana, pot. They'll start smoking more and more pot and just thinking, wow, I've just got to calm down. I've just got to calm down. I got to take the edge off this extremism in the world. It's just everything has somehow become incredibly extreme. And so they'll just be, you know, just become stupefied with drugs, for sure. For sure. And many other ways. They will become stupefied by whatever they do, whatever it is. Eating too much, whatever they indulge in, they say, I've got to somehow get rid of this feeling of, it's all too extreme now, it's all too extreme. This is the feeling that people will be having. It's all too extreme. I just can't handle this. This is too much. It's too extreme. How do I turn the tide? Well, we turn the tide through these positive affirmations. I am innocent. I am innocent. I am innocent. And the capacity to simply hold that affirmation and nothing else. There's nothing else arising in your mind. Just I am innocent. Not entertaining anything else, any thought. Just I am innocent. I am innocent. I am innocent. And in just in a holistic way, not limiting your innocence in any way, not defining it nor limiting it. Okay, simply as a statement of totality. For all that is, I am, which is actually all. All is all. All is innocent. I am innocent. All is innocent. Actually, the same statement. Now, So we're just rolling this out. This is a rollout to counter the rollout of fanaticism in the world. There's going to be the facade of cohesive civility in the planet is going to collapse very soon. Very, very soon. And the rollout of this belligerency, this collapse of civility, is going to be so incredibly intense and fanatical and extreme that it's going to catch people as if in like a dust storm of they're going to feel like they're in a haze of not knowing how to deal with this, okay? But we know how to deal with this here. We know how to deal with this. Jesus has warned me 36 years of intense emergency, all-out preparation warning. You have to be ready for these times because these times are coming. And it will only take certain triggers to trigger it, actually, to trigger the collapse of civility. And you will be amazed. Don't get caught unawares by this. Don't get caught unawares. Have the remedy in hand. Have the remedy with you already. Easily just say, I am innocent. As you go through the day, repeat this. I am innocent. I am innocent. I am innocent. Simply repeat as you go about any of the day right now, wherever you go, I am innocent. I am innocent. I am innocent. You're going to need to do this because there's going to be a massive accusational attitude in the world. Okay? Absolutely massive accusational attitude. And you will certainly feel as if you're being accused. And it's easy to fall into a guilt trip at this time. Very easy to fall into a guilt trip. But we will not allow that here. We will say, I am innocent. I am innocent. I am innocent. Now, so I don't know how Jesus is going to deal with the situation, whether he'll be, Jesus will be here in this world now or working through those who have prepared properly. I don't know. Don't have the information. Anything is possible. But we're not going to hold our breath for anything. We're going to take action. We're going to be proactive here. And we're going to say, I am innocent. I am innocent. We are innocent. All is innocent. All is innocent. That's the real, I am innocent, we are innocent, all is innocent. If you want to use the trinity of affirmation, say that. I am innocent, we are innocent, all is innocent. I am innocent, we are innocent, all is innocent. Okay. I am innocent, we are innocent, all is innocent, all is innocent. Believe me, this is going to be necessary. This is going to be necessary. The attitude of fanaticism and extremism and accusation, they have been working on this for a long time. And so they are ready to bring forward just an incredible, massive blitzkrieg of belligerence, okay, blitzkrieg of belligerence, of accusation, of extremism, of fanaticism, globally. This is a global situation. There's nowhere you can go on this planet that is going to be free from this. So you need to have the answer within you to apply at all times. Anybody can apply it at all times, wherever they are. I am innocent. I am innocent. I am innocent. We are innocent. All is innocent. Remember, do not get caught up in the polarity game of I am innocent, but you're not. All is innocent. When you say I am innocent, it's a holistic I, a oneness I, meaning all eyes are innocent. Okay, all eyes are innocent. I am innocent. It's speaking for everyone. Speaking for everyone, speaking for all. All is innocent. All is innocent. All is innocent. Okay. Very great. This is enough for now, about a half an hour. Just start trying it. Just realize, at least first here, the answer is here on how to turn the tide, how to deflect back all accusation, all guilt. Okay. in the fanatical times that are going to start unfolding, and they're already unfolding, I say, starting today, July 16th, 2014. Very great, that's it.